Hello, beautiful creators. Welcome back to Monzor Media. So today we're going to go over Luminar Neo's latest update, 1.05. The biggest thing with this update has to do with the presets. Now, if you haven't updated Luminar Neo yet, typically when you open it up, you're going to see the prompt to update it, at least on Windows. Then all you have to do is follow the steps and Neo will update on its own. But for whatever reason you don't get the update, you can head over to the menu on the top left here, click on that, go to Help, and then check for updates, and it's going to tell you if there's an update available. As you see on my screen, I've already done that. As we look in the catalog here, you're going to see the presets tab option here, and you simply just have to click on it and you'll see all the presets available there. Another way you can do it is once your image is selected, the shortcut key is T, and then you'll see the presets on the right here. Now, the way the presets work is that Luminar Neo will suggest a preset for your image. You don't have to use it. Based on the AI, it's going to recommend you a preset to use. So in this case, it's Animal Friends. So I'm going to click on that. And then you'll see just below the different categories that you can try out. So if I were to, you know, go through a few of these and see which look that I want to start with, I can go ahead and do that. So I'm going to go ahead and apply one of these presets here. Let's click on Soft Fur. And as you see, it's going to apply the preset to your image. Now, if I decided that I didn't like it and I want to revert to the original and maybe just start from scratch, you could simply just press Ctrl Z and it's going to revert back to the original state. Alternatively, you can just go to the right here and click on this undo button and then it's going to revert to the original. Another thing I want to point out is that if we select a preset here and we go to our edits, previously, like in AI, it used to show you where the edits were done by a little dot beside the effect or feature that was used. That's no longer the case in Neo. Now you're going to see it in the Edits tab. So if we click on Edits, you're going to see that this particular preset used Mood, Super Contrast, Details, Enhance, and so on and so forth. And the benefit of this is that you can go back in here and let's say I want to bring the Enhance down a bit. Maybe the structure, I find it's a little too much and I actually want to bring it down. I can do that here and then it's going to make those adjustments and keep them in the order it was done. Now, should you want to save this as a custom preset that you want to apply to other images, you can go back here, click on the heart. And if we go back to the presets menu, we look at favorites here and you're going to see Soft Fur is now saved as one of my favorites. Now, if you click on the three buttons here, there is an edit button where you can make tweaks to those changes you made. Also, one thing to point out, if you're on the Mac version, I believe you have more options here. When you click the three buttons, you should be able to rename it and even share the preset via email or whatever, but it doesn't seem like it's active on the Windows version. If you wanted to revert your image to its original state, you can go back into the catalog, hover over the picture you're working with, right click, and go to Adjustments, Revert to Original, and then your image will be set back to its original state. A couple smaller updates that they do mention. The first one is in the Develop tool, where if you go into the camera profiles here, you're going to now see an option to add your custom DCP or DCP from DNG. I don't typically use this a lot, but I do remember that not being there previously. So if that's a function that you need, just know that that's available as well. The next thing we're going to look at is under Mood, and this is an addition with the LUTs, the lookup tables. Now, previously in Luminar AI and prior to this update, when you'd add a custom LUT, the LUT would just be applied to your image, and if you wanted to change it, you'd have to go back, you know, into the menu and add a custom LUT, and there would be no way to save them under a category, and you wouldn't really know which LUT you applied because it wasn't listed in the menu. But now if you go into Add Custom LUT, I'm going to go ahead and add this one from the Land of Freedom LUTs that they were promoting not too long ago for Ukraine. I'm going to open it up here. And you see that little animation sequence there? That's really just telling you it's being loaded. And now if I go into the menu here, you're going to see a category for custom LUTs. So now I can add a few of them and really see which of these LUTs that I like. But now I can go into these custom LUTs and you see it's under custom LUTs. I can switch to this one or switch to that one. As I said before, there was no way to do that previously, so this is a really good update in my opinion. Should you not want to keep these LUTs in the menu, there's a trash can icon here to delete them, and you simply click on that and it disappears, and you're pretty much good to go. Until the next video, my friends, get out there, hit record, create, and I'll see you when I see you.